huh, nice challenge you got here. It'd be ashamed if someone messed with it.
No, not the bananas. Oh, God, short circuit, why?
Because we're the best. NVIDIA has done something very unusual for the company. It's published its graphic kernel modules for Linux as open source software. See, AMD regularly open sources all sorts of things, from FreeSync to Vulkan drivers, but Team Green keeps things bottled up inside. Maybe that's why they're green. I don't know.
It's not healthy.
I know. It's just, it's like that emoji, that green emoji.
Yeah.
Ah! And once you look deeper, it's clear that NVIDIA has done this whole open source thing in a very NVIDIA way. They've moved much of the proprietary code into the graphics card firmware, which can be accessed by the driver, but it's not open source itself. The driver also has alpha support for gaming graphic cards from the GeForce 16 series and up, and will only receive periodic updates from NVIDIA, so community input is limited.
Boo.
However, some enthusiasts are still praising the move since it means NVIDIA drivers can now be included with Linux distros. So NVIDIA GPUs can work out of the box without messing up your installation.
Wow. You buy them from Best Buy.
Yeah. Linux news, is this what kids really want these days?
Yeah, that's what my kid tells me he wants.
Linux! A Texas law called HB 20 has just taken effect, which allows the state's citizen or the attorney general to sue social media platforms for banning, demonetizing, or otherwise restricting a user based on their viewpoint. Such a law would make almost every moderation feature used by sites like Twitter, YouTube, and Facebook illegal. Because that sounds pretty whack, the law has been blocked by a court injunction since December, but on Wednesday, a panel of three appeals court judges voted to lift the block because two of them were apparently under the impression that Twitter and YouTube were not websites, but internet service providers.
They're not websites, they're a state of mind.
Yeah, it's a vibe, dude. If the law stands, Twitter could end up being a lot more free, even if Elon doesn't buy it, which might be the case since he says the deal is currently on hold. Elon, what is this, a joke to you? Wait, I know the answer. I'm the joke. And the cryptocurrency universe is still being rocked by the crash of stablecoin Terra USD. Stablecoin.
Just
stablecoin, which has now been delisted from major crypto exchanges like Bitfinex and FTX and had its blockchain disabled by the coin's creators. People are just too afraid, I guess. Everyone's a coward these days except for Apple and crypto bros.
The two heroes of our society.
Please save us, crypto bros. Tether's USDT, another stablecoin that is meant to be pegged to the US dollar, also saw its value drop to 97 cents before recovering thanks to Tether's dumping $300 million into the coin. You may have a strong opinion about crypto, but analysts seem uncertain about whether the bubble is finally bursting. There's a good chance El Salvador might not actually get around to building that golden volcano city shaped like a Bitcoin.
But I already bought real estate. And I paid for it with Luna.
Ooh, I bought it with ETH. Now it's time for Quick Bits, brought to you by XSplit, the trusted live streaming and recording software for gaming, presentations, live events, hot dog competitions, regular dog competitions, but you name it, XSplit's got it all. Broadcaster, the all-in-one streaming and recording solution, Kinect Webcam, which lets you use your phone as a webcam. I actually used it, it's pretty good. Presenter, for adding personality, flair, and interactivity to your stream. Capture, which lets you annotate and add voiceovers to shareable images and video clips. And VCam, our virtual background tool. Get everything you need to make awesome streams and use code Linus at the link below to save 10% today. I don't know why you should call them Quick Bits. You should call them Short Circuits!
No, I'm not. Stop it, Jono. What are those moves?
Support for AMD's FSR 2.0 upscaling has finally rolled out in its first game, Deathloop, after much teasing. Team Red was very naughty, and so far, impressions from Digital Foundry and others are good. While NVIDIA's DLSS and Intel's XESS use machine learning and specialized hardware. FSR 2.0 uses standard GPU compute units to run its temporal upscaling technique, which is tuned by humans instead of AI. So it's a bit more artisanal. You might find this temporal upscaling technique at the local farmer's market instead of the mall.
It's made with hemp.
Reliable Apple analysts Ming-Ching Kuo and Bloomberg's Mark Gurman have both published reports claiming that Apple is currently testing iPhone models with USB-C ports instead of lightning ports. You know, old stuff. No, you haven't been struck by lightning. It seems like EU's upcoming regulations have finally forced Apple to put USB-C into one of the last products that they make that doesn't have it. You gotta admire the dedication to being the most stubborn tech company, though, that they know who they are.
Google, who's Google? Google doesn't know.
Meta?
Facebook?
GPU prices are falling, which means we are gonna see an old relic come back to life. Graphic card game bundles.
Yay! Woohoo! Happy Christmas!
It'll be the third time I got Doom Eternal. See? In ye olden times, GPUs would usually be bundled with a game, but AMD and Nvidia stopped the practice when it became apparently they didn't need any help selling out of the games for the stocks. Sure, the games are often not quite the cream of the crop, but free stuff in any capacity should be welcome right now. Have you seen the freaking gas prices? Ugh!
I haven't. I fly to work.
Bethesda has announced that the release dates for heavily anticipated games Starfield and Redfall have both been delayed into 2023. Ugh. While the delays always suck, it's the same type of suck as like taking the cake out of your oven and realizing it needs another 20 minutes. You don't want to eat goopy cake, or maybe you do. Star Citizen is waiting. And lizard man Mark Zuckerberg has shown off a video of himself trying an augmented reality demo in Meta's upcoming project Cambia VR headset, using only hand tracking controls. Cambia is supposed to be geared more towards work use cases, which is why the demo involved Mark throwing a ball around for a CGI bunny. Someone has to walk Mr. Sprinkles, or he and his family is gonna be deleted.
That's the corporate world.
Well, I guess that's what passes for a Techland video these days. Come back on Monday if you want more whatever this was. But I heard that there's a super cool channel called Short Circuit that you should check out soon.
No, you could not. You can't check it out.
What about They're Just Movies?
Nope. Well, okay, fine. They're Just Movies, fine.
They're Just Movies. But not... Please subscribe.
Where are my bananas?